Good morning, learners.
I am your teacher, Mr. Justin C. Montoya.
Welcome to
Just Learn Season 2.
Join me
as I discuss our lesson for today, which is about clear structures and shapes.
At the end of this video lesson,
I am expecting that you should be able to, number one, identify real structures and shapes. Number two, prepare the necessary tools and equipment for the specific field care activity. And number three, perform basic preventive and corrective maintenance.
A few reminders before we start.
Number one, watch and listen carefully. Number two, take down notes. Number three, pause and play this video for better understanding. Number four, replay this video for clear concepts. And number five, enjoy learning.
Nails are specialized form of skin. Nail is a plate of therapy that lies on the tips of the fingers and toes.
The main purpose of nails is to serve as a layer of protection for our fingers and toes. We use our hands for all intents and purposes, and nails probably for little things, scratching and many other things. But while dealing with nails, hands and toes, we don't give them suitable consideration they need. Unhygienic nails can not only prompt numerous diseases, but also can eventually deliver germs and bacteria to our mouth without even paying attention to it. Let us now discuss the nail and teeth structure. The picture shows the different structure of the nails. The nail consists of three parts: nail body, nail root, and free edge. First is the nail body or nail tape. This is the visible portion of the nail that is attached to the nail bed. Next is the nail root. This is the beginning of nail found at the base and is embedded underneath the skin. And lastly, the free edge. This is the end portion of the nail, which extends beyond the fingertip and is shaped during manicure. Aside from the nail body, nail root, and the free edge, there is also a structure that can be found beneath the nail. The structures beneath the nail includes the nail bed, matrix, and the lunula. Nail bed is the skin upon which the nail body or nail plate rest. It is supplied with many blood vessels and nerves. The blood vessels supply nourishment for the nail. Next is the matrix. This is the part of the nail bed which contains nerves and blood vessels and is located beneath the nail root. It produces cells that generate and harden the nail and will continue to grow as long as it receives nutrition and remains in a healthy condition. And lastly, the lunula. Lunula is the half-moon shape found at the base of the nail, where the matrix connects with the nail. Also, there is a structure surrounding the nail. The structure surrounding the nail includes the cuticle, aponeurium, hyponeurium, perineurium, nail walls, and nail grooves. Cuticle is the overlapping skin around the nail. A normal cuticle should be loose and pliable. Next is the aponeurium. This is the cuticle extension at the base of the nail body, which partly overlaps with the lunula. Third is the hyponeurium, portion of the skin under the free edge of the nail. We also have nail walls, or the folds of the skin overlapping the sides of the nail. We also have nail grooves. These are the slits or tracks in the skin at the side of the nail upon which the nail curves as it grows. And lastly, we have mantle. It's the deep fold, the skin in which the nail root is embedded. And that is the structure of the nails. Now, let's find out if you have learned anything about the structure of nail. Get your paper and your pencil to write down your answers. You will go in to identify what part of the nail is being described in the following statement. Number one, this is the end portion of the nail plate which extends beyond the finger tip. Number two, what do you call the happening shape found at the base of the nail where the matrix connects to the nail bed? Number three, it is the folds of the skin overlapping the sides of the nail. Number four, what do you call the slits or cracks in the skin at the side of the nail upon which the nail moves as it grows? Number five, it is the beginning of the nail found at the base and is embedded underneath. Let us see if your answers are correct. Number one, free edge. Number two, lunula. Number three, nail walls. Number four, nail grooves. And number five, nail roots. I am hoping that you got all the answers correct. Now, let us discuss the different shape of the nail. Try to look at your nails. What is the shape of your nails? Is it pointed, square, round, scoval, or oval? Let us now discuss the characteristics of every nail shape. First is the oval nail. This is common among people with long, perfect nail beds. It may be styled slightly rounded at the base and slightly pointed at the fingertips. Most often, this type of nail has a natural look and looks very good in a short, medium length. Next is the round nail. This is ideal for shorter nails. The nail is allowed to grow out straight the sides for approximately 1.5 millimeters, and then the tip is filed into a rounded shape. This is a strong shape which is great for those who keep their nails short. Third is the stiletto or pointed nails. This nail is filed away at the sides to a point at the tip. This is very weak, as the sides of the nail, which provided strength, are totally lost. Fourth, we have the scoval. As the oval shape follows the squaring of the tip, this gives the nail tip strength over the oval shape. And lastly, is the square nail. This is the square shape of nails and the most famous among the nail shapes. It is created by allowing the nail to grow out straight and then firing the tip straight across the right angle with the rest of the nail tip. We now reach the end of our lesson. I hope that you gain knowledge and understanding about nail care services. Again, This has been your dear teacher, Mr. Justin C. Montoya. Thank you for watching, listening, and participating. See you on the next episode of
Just Learn Season 2.